So today we're going to cover creating a shroud, and I'm going to do it in reverse because the shroud is already on my vehicle in front of the radiator and the engine fan. That's the shroud. Now, as you can see, it's custom built. If you want the original Nissan stuff, well then you can buy that and put it on, but you would also have to have the original stock radiator, and I don't have that. My radiator is extra big, and thus I needed to create an extra big shroud, and I decided to create that out of zinc flat sheet metal, bend it using a rivet gun. You can see where I'm showing you the different angles of it. And you would have to move that hose, of course, to get it in. Now, if you already have a shroud, you know, this video isn't going to be of much use to you unless you're planning to create a new shroud. The purpose of the shroud is to enforce air from your fan into the radiator so it can cool. If you don't have the shroud there, then the fan just blows wherever. But having a shroud makes sure that the air is pushed through the radiator to cool it. That's how it looks from underneath. I use rubbers on it to prevent the sheet metal from touching the radiator. I'm showing you where I bolted it on. I mean, you would have to come up with your own design, because it's more than likely you won't have the exact same radiator that I have. But I'm just showing you what I did. You know, put a hole in the sheet metal, put on a screw or nut and bolt, whatever have you, whatever works for your radiator, you can do that. Whatever works to mount it. Now, it looks simple there, the way it came out, but you know, making sure that it's fitted on, you need those side mounts. I have another one here, so I use the mount on that side. And I'm not showing you well on the camera, but I'm also showing where I have a screw here. And notice how I cut around the radiator hose. And I put a rubber. You don't want, the last thing you want is your shroud cutting your hose. The idea of it being there is to help, not to make things worse for you. So if you're making it out of metal, make sure there are no sharp ends, there are no ends touching rubber or even other parts of the engine or your battery or anything that may cause problems. This is under the vehicle, and you can see where I created another place for it to be bolted down. So it's not only bolted on the side and the top, but the bottom as well. This ensures that the shroud doesn't move. It remains stationary. That's another thing, you don't want that shroud jumping up and down, moving wherever, because that could cause lots and lots of issues for you. So here we are going to take out the radiator fluid, just enough for that top hose to be removed without sending fluid all over the place. I'm using a large dropper, I think they call it a turkey dropper. By the way, I'm vegan, so no turkey for me. Anyway, I'm taking it out. Shouldn't be much really, and once it's out, that top hose can be removed, and then you can fully pull out the shroud. Or in this case, because I'm doing this in reverse, you would need to pull out that top hose in order to put in the shroud, and then of course put it back. You don't need to take out the whole hose, because you know, it's just, you would need to actually drain more fluid in order to dance. It's really not necessary. Just holding back the radiator hoses, you know. So I'm loosening the clamp. By the way, I have a video on flushing the radiator. If you haven't seen it, make sure to check it out. Now, really, you would want that hose being pulled back. You could use a piece of wire or something to pull it back, or somebody to help you. That way you don't cause damage to the grill of the radiator when you're pulling out that shroud or putting it in. So this is what my shroud looks like, so that you can have a better idea when you create your own. You know, just cut out the shape measure to your radiator, and then put the sides, flaps, whatever you think you need. Use a rivet gun.